everyone. Thank you for joining me. There just isn't enough hours in the day, or the hours of the day just go by too quick. I saw this earthquake early this morning. There was a magnitude 4.8 earthquake near Mina, Nevada. And shortly afterwards, in fact, about 5 minutes later, there was a magnitude 2.8. So far today, there's been 43 earthquakes in this one location. These earthquakes occurred in an area what they call the Mina deflection. This is part of the Walker Lane, which is one day going to be the dominant fault zone, which absorbs about 20 to 25% of the tectonic plate movement. We have a battle going on with the Pacific plate and the North American plate. The North American plate is moving southwest, with the Pacific plate subducting underneath the North American plate. Now, even though the North American plate is moving southwest, the Walker Lane fault zone is moving northwest. And there's a block of the Earth's crust, which involves, let me show you, let me bring this out, part of the Mano Caldera. And this block runs, let me bring it out a little bit more, from the Bodie Hills all the way down to the White Mountains, and it's doing a clockwise rotation. And the area of all these earthquakes is where all that stress has built up multiple fault zones in that area. I guess if you can picture how this block of the Earth crust is rotating. And not all the faults are moving at the same speed or the same amount every year. But this is an area outside of that block, and it's called the Mina deflection. I have several papers I'll give you links to. You can read it. Here it says the Mina deflection is a rotating block of land between the White Mountains and the Bodie Hills. Picture the Mina deflection as a rotating chunk of earth bounded by faults. It is a warped zone between the Eastern Sierra, White Mountain Fault, Fish Lake Valley Fault, Owens Valley Fault, that are moving in a northwest direction. And the Walker Lane Fault is also moving in a northwest direction, but not in the same way. These faults aren't perfectly parallel to each other either, and they aren't moving at the same rate. Like a piece of Play-Doh rolled between your hands, the clockwise rotation of the Mina deflection absorbs the strain between these two western Great Basin fault systems. This area is capable of having a magnitude 6.5 or greater earthquake. You see, we got one here that was in 1934. Back then, the population was really sparse. There was a few chimney collapsed, two cabins were damaged, and there was rock slides. The magnitude 7.1 earthquake, which they had down there by Ridgecrest, is also part of the Walker Lane fault zone. Like I said, it's trying to extend, it's trying to become the dominant fault, and slowly rupturing, going northwest. We'll go back up here to where the recent earthquakes are occurring. There hasn't been any earthquakes, I would say, larger than a magnitude 5 lately. Now, there was a 4.9. That was in 2020, June 19th, to be more precise. And as you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. I feel that people should be aware of the threat of the Walker Lane fault zone and how it's slowly transferring its energy, going further and further north. So you should be prepared for an earthquake of a magnitude 7 or greater. So did you feel this earthquake? If so, please put those comments down below. How did your pets react days before it happened. Nature is always the best indicator of things to come. I want to thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.